Next topic is garbage collector. Though this is not directly related to inheritance, I am taking up this in inheritance module. The reason is, I think we need to discuss this before going ahead with the next topics. So I do not want to take this at a later point of time. Fine. What is a garbage collector? A garbage collector keeps running in the background within JVM and it deallocates the memory. See, in Java, we are allocating the objects using new keyword. We have created a number of objects until now using new keyword. Did we try to delete those objects anywhere? Did we worry about that? We did not worry about it. So who is cleaning it up? JV, garbage collector within JVM is cleaning it. So it keeps running in the background and automatically it keeps on freeing up unreferenced objects. So you may ask me, see, there are multiple segments in a program. One is heap segment, one is stack segment, the other is code segment and data segment. Data segment is the where all we have all the static data and all. Code segment where we have the source, not the source code, is the compiled and the binary code. And stack segment is basically whenever you invoke a method, an entry gets added to the stack. And similarly, we have a heap segment. So what is this heap segment? Here, all the dynamic memory, whichever you allocate using new keyword, is being stored in the heap. And you need not worry about deallocating it. Garbage collector will automatically take care of deallocating it when the execution goes out of that specific scope. So if it is a very small program and you are using less memory, it doesn't make much difference. But if you are trying to use huge memory from the heap, then you may go out of memory. So we'll be exploring out of memory exception in exceptions module. Okay. So when there are no references to an object, it is assumed that it is no longer needed. And hence the garbage collector goes and deletes that, it frees up the memory. Then you may have a question that, okay, garbage collector goes and deallocates memory. So garbage collector automatically keeps running in the background. So you may ask me, like, is there any control? Like, can I invoke that garbage collector from my program? Even though it keeps running in the background, I want to invoke it maybe frequently so that my objects get deleted. Means there is a method GC available in the system class. We have been using system class, right? We have a system class for printing, system.out.println. Okay. So similarly, there is a GC method in system. So system.gc. Fine. So GC is a static method which is available in system class, and hence I'm directly invoking without using the object of the system. So system.gc. When you invoke this system.gc, there's no guarantee that the garbage collector gets activated immediately. It may take some time. So it is not a command, it is just a request which is being put to the garbage collector to clean up the objects in your program. I just try to show it with a diagrammatically. So garbage collector runs periodically and it takes all the unreferenced objects and it cleans up, it reclaims the memory, so that you will have more free space in the memory and it can be utilized for any other purpose in the long running applications. Javad.